Welcome to the CA classroom. Today let us see what is a standard called AS24 discontinuing operations. Now, understand, let us take any company which has multiple businesses. Now, out of all the businesses, they have decided to sell off a business. My question is, like how you want to sell your mobile or car, you might find a buyer in few weeks or months. For a business which runs in crores, if it wants to sell a separate segment of its business, it will not be able to find a buyer in a few days or few weeks. Company's total net profit comes from all these businesses. Now, let us say company decided to sell off a business in 2015. But they were actually able to find a buyer and sell the business only in 2019. It took them 4 years to find a buyer. I will give you two options. The minute you decide to sell a particular part of your business, let's say a small segment, do you close that segment and wait for a buyer, or do you keep using it until you find a buyer? Assume you have a car and you want to sell it. Until you find a buyer, it will not be like the car will be in the shed. You will still keep using it. Same way, the business will still be in operational, maybe a little less than 100% capacity, until an actual buyer is found. So what the standard tells is, the regular P&L and balance sheet format which you prepare is for a going concern business. So the total profit from here, I can expect this in the next few years also. But however, for a discontinuing operation, suddenly 1 year, your profit will drop because one business is going to be sold, which you have decided in 2015, but execution is happening only in 2019 or 2020. So what the standard is telling is, for the next few years, prepare your P&L and balance sheet as it is, but also give an additional disclosure saying, out of the total profit of 100, 80 I will be getting in the future, 20, the day somebody buys this business, this 20 profit I will no more get. So this standard tells me how to account for a discontinuing operation and how to show a presentation for this, because normal format is for a company which has going concern. This company is also going to continue, but a part of it is going to be sold. So during the period until I find a buyer, what kind of disclosures have to be made so that my users will know what is the actual profit I can expect in the future. So the very first thing you need to understand is, understand what is a discontinuing operation, and the standard has a definition for that. Now, let us look at the definition of what is a discontinuing operation. In the previous section, we have understood why I cannot present a discontinuing operation together with a continuing operation. So, I need to disclose all my assets, liabilities, profits from continuing operations and discontinuing operations separately in my financial statements until the operations are finally sold off. Now, before doing that, we need to understand what is a discontinuing operation. AS24 defines what is a discontinuing operation. It has a big definition, but fairly simple. First, it says, discontinuing operation is a component of the enterprise. Discontinuing operation is a component of the enterprise. So I have my entire entity, it is a small component of an enterprise, a separate component of an enterprise. It cannot be a single asset, single liability or single item, a separate component of my enterprise. That the enterprise pursuant to a single plan. So they would have decided this in a particular board meeting or in an AGM or a meeting of the top people of the company. They will want this to happen in a single plan. Next. How am I going to sell this component or relieve this component away from my business
There are three ways to do it: A, B, and C. But before that, let us see what the definition NPAT says. Whatever component I am going to sell off or separate it from my business, that component should represent a major line of the business. For example, many years back, Nestle company started a small business of manufacturing and selling water bottles. Now, Nestle is a company involved in manufacturing and selling various chocolates. Water bottle was a very small part of the business, accounting only for 50 to 60 crores of the total revenue. They had sold this segment away separately. Now, does this represent major line of business? No. Major line means of your total business size, it should be a major line of the entire business. Represents a major line of the business. Let's say, of all the businesses, one small business which accounts for just 1 or 2% of the revenue is being sold out, it will not be a discontinuing operation. No. It represents a major line of business or geographical area of operations. Now let us say Apple company is operating throughout the globe. Tomorrow they decide we are going to discontinue all our operations in Asian countries. Now that will be a discontinuing operations because it represents a major line of business or geographical area. So I am going to do the same business everywhere, but one major geographical chunk of area I am going to stop doing business for any reason. Next. And represents a major line of business or geographical area of operations. And so it has to be either a major line of business or in a geographical area. And that particular component is identified separately for operating and financial reporting purposes. What do I mean for this? That particular branch or particular business of mine has separate managers, separate segment for operating, separate team doing that business, and I have separate financial statements prepared for that separate segment of my business. Let us say there is a pharma company involved in manufacturing of medicines and also involved in wholesale and retail business. In this wholesale and retail business, they do retail of various other brands. Now, they want to sell off this wholesale and retail business. This wholesale and retail business for the pharma company will be identified separately for its operating and financial reporting purposes. Also, it accounts for a major line of business. Now, what are the three ways in which you can dispose this component, take it away from my business? First, pursuant to a single plan, disposing of substantially in its entirety the component. Meaning, let us say for pharma business, I have manufacturing unit and wholesale and retail. You need to sell off the entire part substantially. You cannot tell 50% I'll sell today, 50% I'll sell later. Substantial part of the component has to be sold. How will I sell? Through a single sale transaction. Entire component is going to be purchased by one person. Let's say another company, let's say Sun Pharma is going to purchase this. Single sale transaction, one contract, lump sum amount, take away the entire business. Or by demerger. All of you might be aware of demerger. Splitting of business, making it two separate entities. Separate legal entity, one company. I am demerging it, making it two separate companies. Or hive off the component to the enterprise shareholders. Meaning what? I am selling the business to my shareholders itself. This is one way of disposing the business. Second, disposing component assets in piecemeal manner. Meaning what? I was not able to find a buyer. Now let's say you have your house and your house is furnished with AC, fan, TV, light. You wanted to sell the entire house along with the assets inside it. But people were not ready. They wanted to buy only the house and not the assets inside. So what you started doing? Sell the AC to a separate person. Sell the fan to a separate person. Sell the tube light to a separate person. So this is called disposing the component assets in a piecemeal manner. Each person gets a separate asset. And settling the liabilities individually. Get this money and settle the liabilities. Last way is terminating by abandonment. This is a very rare case. What is this? Let's say you had a business, you invested 20 crores in Syria and you started a business 20-30 years back. Things were going fine, but suddenly a war broke out there and things are not fine there. Now can I wait over there saying, come, I want a buyer. Once I find a buyer, I will sell this. No. You cannot do anything. You just have to leave it. Terminate my assets over there. Forget the investment. Abandon it. Throw away your investment. Cannot do anything because now it is not in your control. There is a war in that place. So this is the definition for what is a discontinuing operation. Now let us see what happens once a company decides to sell a component of a business. How do they take a decision and how do I present the same in my financial statements? In the previous section, we had exhaustively seen what is definition of a discontinuing operation. Now let us see what is an initial disclosure event, meaning this will trigger AS 24 for the presentation. Before we see this, let me take a small example and I want you guys to understand, are these discontinuing operations or not? Let us take Nestle company, which has hundreds of chocolates in its brand. Let's say Nestle wants to shift its operations from its current head office to Chennai. Shifting its production facilities, is this discontinuing operation? No. Out of all the 100 products, let's say some chocolates are not purchased by consumers. So they want to stop manufacturing 2 to 3 brands of chocolates. Is this discontinuing operation? No. Because it does not represent major line. Third, they are slowly and gradually reducing sale of few products. Slowly and gradually reducing the sale of few products and increasing some other new products. Is this discontinuing operation? Absolutely not. Discontinuing operation should fall within your definition. Now let us see what is an initial disclosure event. It says, there should be a board approval of formal plan of discontinuance and public announcement. Assume the top directors of the company discuss among themselves to sell off a line of business. It is not AS 24. It is not triggering AS 24. There should be meeting in the board meeting. People should discuss over this and then a board resolution has to be passed. Not only board resolution, company should be satisfied. You need to satisfy all the employees, all your customers, all your suppliers. Basically, your stakeholders should approve for it. Next, you will make a public announcement. After making a public announcement, you need to find a buyer. After finding a buyer, enterprise should enter into a binding sale agreement. What do I mean by binding sale agreement? Not just one director will sign on behalf of the company. Entire company as a whole should agree and sign in the sale agreement. So once both these are completed, one, board approval, public announcement and entering into a binding sale agreement, then if a business has 4 segments, one part of the segment will become a discontinuing operation. Once it becomes a discontinuing operation, next we will see how to present this in the financial. Now let us see how to present this in your financial statements. We have 2 parts. One is your profit and loss account and balance sheet. The other part is your notes to accounts. Before we get into the presentation, let us take a small timeline to understand this. Let's say in the year 2015, the company decides to sell the business. However, only in the year 2016, they pass a board resolution and they make a public announcement. They keep searching for buyers, and only in the year 2018 they got a buyer who's ready to purchase the business. And in the year 2019, let us say he has paid 30% of the purchase consideration, and let's say in the year 2020 he pays the balance consideration. So now how do we present? You will start presentation only from the year 2016 when there is a formal plan for selling the business. You are basically telling your shareholders, going forward in the future, your business size is going to reduce. How do we present this in your profit and loss account? You will write your current year values, previous year values. As usual, you will write your income. And then I will write my expenses. And I will write my profit before tax. From your profit before tax, I should show the breakup. How much is from continuing operations and how much is from discontinuing operations. Next, total tax paid. For this also I have to show breakup of how much is from continuing operations and how much is from discontinuing operations. Last will be profit after tax. For this also I have to show breakup. How much is from continuing operations and how much is from discontinuing operations. Why do I show such kind of a breakup? So that the users will understand only continuing operations profit I can expect in the long run. Coming to your notes to accounts. Here you will show a summary statement. What kind of a statement? I will prepare a two column statement. One will be values of continuing operation. Next will be values from my discontinuing operations. I will write my income, expense and profit. Profit after tax. Next you will also write breakup of assets and liabilities for my continuing operations and discontinuing operations. And lastly, you will prepare a cash flow statement and show breakup for your operating activities, financing activities and investing activities. How much is from continuing operations and how much is from discontinuing operations. Apart from your existing presentation, this will be additional presentation which starts from 2016, the year in which a board resolution is passed. Till when will you continue? You will continue until you receive the consideration from the buyer. Every year this will continue. What you have to disclose in 2018, same thing plus 2018 you will disclose saying we have found a buyer in this year. In 2019 you will disclose saying 30% of the consideration is received. In 2020 you will say this discontinuing operation no more belongs to us from this date. It is taken over from the other party from this date and so much of consideration is received by me. So after 2016 where you make your initial disclosures, you will continue these disclosures by giving updates on what is happening on this transaction. So the user will know that until when he will get this money. This standard is more of a presentation and disclosure. You talks about what to disclose and what to present in your financial statements and reason for the sale. You also have to give information as to what is the reason why I am selling the business, who is buying it, how am I looking for buyers, which buyer did I choose. All this information has to be given in your financial statements. Ordinarily, not many of you will come across this standard practically in practice. Only a very few of us will be exposed to this standard and what presentation has to be done for a company where AS 24 is applicable. This is about AS 24. We will discuss some problems in the live class. Thank you.